Yo, it's good with y'all, man. Welcome y'all back to another video. It's your boy Hustle, it's your boy 98 CEO, aka The Answer. I'm back with another video. And what I got for this video, man, and so I'm sure y'all know in the times, J. Cole has dropped another song. If y'all didn't see, I just reacted to the Daylight J. Cole Play the Collard Greens song that dropped it 2 days ago. And I mean, that was like 2 weeks ago. It came out 2-3 weeks ago. But what's today? Friday? Thursday night, J. Cole dropped a song called Port Antonio. And I seen it like that night at like maybe like 11:30, 11, it was just on YouTube. And I was like, interesting. I'm gonna probably get to it. So, have heard the song, so I'm not gonna say it's like a first reaction. But I am gonna review the song, go over with y'all, break down some of the lyrics, because I ain't gonna lie, the boy is talking. And I kind of got a view from this whole thing. I kind of just, I don't know how to necessarily formalize it in like a comparison way, like in basketball players, like football players, like that. But J. Cole might be like, I don't know, bro. He just, his song making ability in a way where it's not like a song that makes sense. Like this is this song, for instance. It's like he's just rapping the whole song. It's not really no hook, but it's just like, it's just like a great song. Like, a lot of songs. This song good. I like this song a lot. So we finna get straight to that song. So we got the visualizer, Port Antonio, J. Cole. Oh, we got J. Cole, Port Antonio. Official visualizer came out yesterday. And got 2.9 million views. So we finna get straight into that video. I got J. Cole, Port Antonio. We finna get straight to that video. I ain't got the boy talking. I'm turning that a little bit. And that's, and bruh, like his choice of beats and samples is just like, bruh. It be, that was the person that got me. I gotta turn it back up. I forgot my samples there. That just sound like the samples off the rip tell me like, okay, it's like a journey, like a life journey, like somebody going through some trial or tribulation. So that's what that tell me in the background. Like, I don't know what he's saying back there, but he can say whatever you want to be saying. Say keep going, whatever. He's saying, come on, like. Hey, talk to another boy. Say, hey, all right. I like that. Bring that back in song, but let ride for a little second. Like, think about the person that wants to just go in the car and ride. Like, don't just give me. I mean, ETSG, my boy, but ETSG started at 0.0001. Foul rolling, you know. Sometimes I just want to ride in the car and just be look at the serene. Like, we just vibing. Like, I just see nature, and it's like, I see how J. Cole be riding his, you know, his bike through the juice. He probably got these in his headphones. Just listen to this, like, yeah, that's hard. Ryan, dude, like, let me hear the beat. All right, now. Ride, hey. Ride to it. Like, take a little journey with me right now. Hey, ride to it. Narrow wage jobs for the narrow cash was on a zero. Yeah, I fiend for the perks that was seen flipping birds, so we were skipping church, but my eyes was on the And I ain't okay, that whole list, like, I ain't okay. J. Cole wasn't the slickest just talkers, because I ain't okay. That boy, the way he was talking, bro, he said they want to talk about my I'm gonna wait till you get there. But even just like this, like he said, hold on, but I ain't okay. All right, I don't spare one coming. But he said that, you know, I fiend for these perks of XYZ perks, literally perks, but he's saying just the perks of this situation. Like the perks that you get from the job, the perks you get from this phone, the perks you get from this car. He said, I just, you know, think of the perks of that and became a fiend to that. That I was literally like, I was taking perks. I was just a fiend to the perks of this lifestyle that is like, it's like, I might as well should just been a fiend of perks. That's the equivalency of it. That, like, that's deep. And that's just on the quick, like, that's on the first quote. What is it? Ride, we still ride. Narrow. Fiend for the perks that was fiends for the... for the birds, and they said, but my I was on the sparrow. On the zeros, hey. I fiend for the perks, yeah. That was seen flipping birds. So we were skipping But my was on the spare road. Come on now. He said, I fiended for the perks of, you know, what people did who was slipping the birds. I fiended for the perks of that. That lifestyle, the cars, the money, the girls. I fiended for that. But, you know, I was still going to church. You know, my, I was on the sparrow. You know, I, they was flipping birds, but my eyes was on the sparrow. I was thinking about this. That's, come on, bro. Come on, bro. It's rap. Whoa, Draco. Let's go. Still, my mind was on the zeros. Yeah. I fiend for the perks that was seen flipping birds. So we were skipping church. But my eyes was on the sparrows. Niggas flipping pies, spending thousands on a payroll. Shit, I want to shine too. Two. I want dimes too. Yeah. Jealous niggas want to know just how. Back birds. You know, I want dimes too. You know, they flipping birds. I want some dimes too. I'm trying to give me some cash, so I want some pie too. But dimes literally flipping dimes. Come on now, Cole. I'm on that. Tell about talking. Two. I want ten. I want the girl too. Dude. Hey. Two. Bono. Come on now, y'all. Everybody know that U2 album was on your iPhone. You had the old enough iPhone, but U2 1 was on that album. Come on now. Y'all better lock in. Just how my rhymes blew. Mono, we mono, I'm bono. I'm bono, we times two. You too. Now I'm bougie, out and out, cool, the fountain blue. Yeah. But never forgot the spot the where I developed my plot. To dwell at the top, the veil where all my skeletons lie. Locks. If I could do it all over, then I never would swap. Yeah. I seen good, I seen bad, had my melanin mic. Mm. I seen lifelong friends turn to devilish ops. Yeah. I was Mike and red leather trying to tell them to stop. You better beat it. Come on now, do you know the beat it video though? You know Mike was in there, he just stopped, chill, they lean, and you know, they got into it, come on, they got into it, you know, he said, I was Mike, you know, and it's crazy, because, it's double entendre, I was Mike, you know, in the middle, like, telling him to stop, this before it even started, he's like, I was Mike in the middle, like, telling him to stop, so that's when he grabbed the mic, literally, on Dreamville, and said, hey, Kendrick Lamar, one of the greatest rappers in the game, you know, I didn't, you know what I mean, whatever he said. That was him saying, I'm Mike right now, I'm grabbing the mic, hey, I'm the MC, I got the mic, I'm saying this, boom. But it's like the beat it video, I'm telling him like, two, but in between, like, boy, y'all stop before I go there. And we know what happened. And yeah, come on, that's deep. Devilish ops, I was Mike and red leather trying to tell him to stop. You better beat it before you see the heavy metal get pop. He was a mean ass way with a hell of a shot. Yeah. But if no team draft, King, he be down the block. Come on now. That's like, that's what I'm saying. Like, this is slick. He said, but you know what I'm saying? If don't no team draft King, then he, and damn. It just hit me. Let's see how even deeper that is. Like, he's saying that if the, you know, the team don't draft him, you know. If DraftKings literally the sports betting app, but saying if they don't draft King from where he at, literally a team, because you know a lot of situations, you know, or how can they can be in some of our communities where all we want to do, I want to be a sports player, I want to be a football player, I want to be baseball, that's kind of far out. Everybody just don't want to be a baseball player, but I want to be football, basketball, you know, baseball, you know, something different. And just like, so he's saying if a team don't draft King, then he gonna bet on the block. He was just gonna put all his money on the block. He gonna put everything on the block. He gonna hedge his whole life on the block. But literally, like, if he's on draft King, then he was just betting on LeBron get the block today. Come on now. I'm telling you, Cole's sleep. Shots. King, he gonna bet on the block. Shot, bet on the block. Come on. Oh. Cause he's still on it. He gonna bet on the block. He wanna ball till he fall into the federal's knock. And sit his ass on a bitch for moving careless with rock. You can't relate unless your father was not a. And just think about it, like how far he took you. He didn't take you on the whole journey. You know what I'm saying? They started with the birds, that's with the birds, and now he got, you know, now the feds had you, though, they knocked because they done found you with the rock. They got you with the rock. This is what happened, but you know what I'm saying? You've been betting on the block. You've been betting it all on the block all the time. To sit his ass on a bitch for moving careless with rock. Yeah. You can't relate unless your father was not around. Your mother went out in town. Someone else and then brought around. Yeah. These salaries didn't combine. When they married, they brought you around. Out of that poverty, they do. This, like, that whole little scheme right here, it's just like, bro, you could visualize that whole situation. Like, damn. He encompassed that in so many great words. Like, it was amazing. Listen. You can't relate unless your father was not around and your mother went out and found someone else and then brought around and their salaries didn't combine when they married and brought you out and that poverty in your womb to a soft little part of town so that when you back in the hood you feel awkward about it now. Like, think about that. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, your pops was not around, your mama didn't, or whatever, you know, with your pops, but Your mama, you know, she went and found another man, you know, bring a man to the house, and you know, they put their two stuff together, their two incomes together. So y'all moved on up. Y'all Jefferson moving on up. And now you don't stay in the hood no more, you're in the suburbs. Or you're just in a better, you know, part of the you're just in a better place in general. And then now when you go back to hood, you feel awkward about it now, like, I don't relate to my same people who I've been with this whole time. I don't relate to them in the same way because we're not in the same circumstance. We're not in the same situation no more. That's deep. And that boy just walked that dog. No cap. Well, awkward about it now. Like, think about how many people that really hit for. Like, listen to that boy. And it, cause that's what dude every time. Don't, like, that's what I love about Sam. Don't start singing to me in the background what he talking about. He talking about some real life shit. That's somebody real life, for real. So now you go back to that, you feel awkward about it now. And your confidence start to drop. Like, that's somebody, he's speaking to somebody. And then, so they put you back in the hood, my girl. She got a little loud, about to clown. I'm about to down. Now, hey. The second version, though, hey, just slow it down. Ride with me. Ride too. Right, two, but no lie about it. Verse 2 got two. Verse 2, if you wanted straight here for just that, verse 2 got straight to it. Verse 1 was just ride to it. It's time to get to it. But he's talking the whole time. Come on now. Cold. World. Come on now. You thought we was getting straight to the bridge now. Now it's the bridge. Wait.
Y'all niggas ain't stopping me. Y'all niggas ain't stopping me.
Now you just need 20 seconds of that. We still on the ride. This one, you gotta take a long drive to. You gotta play at least twice. So you can't just go up the block. You gotta go at least 20 minutes. Come on now.
Stop me.
Hey.
Stop me.
Yeah. Flows. Time. You gotta search, find, stop it. Stop. That might be the hardest bar in the whole thing, to be honest with you. To find deliveries like mine, you gotta search primes. Like, J. Cole, you think you slick? You think you getting that by me, dog? Deliveries, you gotta search primes. Like, you saying, like, rap, like, oh, damn, you wanna hear my delivery? Like, how I talk, the way I'm from that club. You gotta go back to the primes of these folks, like, back in the days, you know what I'm saying? The Nas, the J's. He said, you gotta go back there, but no. Cole, the deliveries, primes. If you want to find my delivery, you gotta check to see primes. Or Amazon, Prime. You gonna get these deliveries, you gotta order this. You gotta get this, like, this is custom right here. This ain't that, but we can get to you quick. We can get to the same day. Cause we got the Prime, you know, we do deliveries. But for you to find my delivery, you gotta look in the primes of people in the past. This ain't Amazon. This ain't that quick hit. It's like a quadruple entendre. Drake said he wanted one, so there you go. Like, I ain't one of them, like, this microwavable things that you can just order, and I'm here. So, to find my delivery, you gotta go back in the day to the prime of this. But at the same time, if you call for me, I can't get there in 2 business days, for sure. And it sounds like he ship on weekends, too.
I'm scared of heights higher than birds can perch, Trump.
No, sir. Because you're not going to tell me how you're scared of heights higher than birds, higher than where birds perch. No, sir, Cole. Start me from the top.
Yeah.
Calm. But in cold flows, reverse time. Like mine, gotta search.
I'm scared of heights higher than birds can perch. Trying to be something. Hoping that peace comes to my cursed mind. One thing's for sure that I've matured from my first rhyme. Yeah. I learned long ago you can't please them all.
And it hurts trying. That just sound like a man. I mean, I've been giving up on that. I know I can't. I knew going in that I wouldn't be able to please everybody. I knew going in that I couldn't do it, but just the way this is going, that's sitting right with me. That's what it sounds like.
My
return. Please them all, and it hurts trying.
In this game, where all you got is your name, like dirt.
I'm smirking
it. I'm
absurd
times. The fate you told it is wise. I can see hate in both
for your eyes, but the third's blind. Like, come on, bro. I can see hate in both of your eyes, but the third's blind. Like, and it's just like the flow is like the diction, the voice. Like, that's why I said the last video. Cole, you hear every word he's saying. It's like art. This is like the art form of hip hop. Like, You saying, and I ain't got a problem with mumble rapping, but because for me, a lot of the mumble rap, they say mumble rap, I can hear what they saying. It's just the flow. But like, he's concise. You can hear every word he's saying. Very clear in his diction. You can hear. I mean, he's very clear. So that's just like, to me, the art form of hip hop. J. Cole is called hip hop. Now listen, you like both of your eyes, but the first one. So you search lines, but you struggle, which explains the puzzle look on the dull faces, the word finds. I hate what rats become, but like, do not. Like, do you see what he said? He said that. So it makes sense that y'all be dull when y'all hear the words. Like, y'all don't, it don't even hit y'all. Y'all don't even get it. Listen. Which explains the puzzle look on the dull faces, the word finds. Yeah. I hate what rats become, but like, do not disturb signs. Cannot get it if I know it's about the dough. Cannot get it if I know it sees about the dough. You know what I'm saying? He said, like, do not disturb sign. Like, if you go to a hotel, do not disturb sign on the door. I can't knock it. I can't knock on your door. You said, do not disturb. Cool. But just like, do not disturb signs. I can't knock it if it's about the dough. Like, I understand these folks just trying to get some money. So I can't really knock you for not having the art form in a high place or respecting the craft or kind of putting in the work of some of us that had to do that or... Not even necessarily had to, wanted to. Some just might have wanted to do it. So I can't knock you for not having to go through that, but I mean, I'm just gonna put on do not disturb, it's not for me, straight up. Not right now. No, because that's what I'm saying, like, the progression of this, like, he said, you know, they saying, third signs, cannot get it by seeing by the door. They instigate the fuckery because it's profitable. Yeah. But second, it makes that chocho. Hospital, now pull the plug. I see where that was about to go. You know what I'm saying? They, you know, they preach the peace. They preach, you know, this, but, you know, they you know what I'm saying? They saying that with the dude hitting while he in the hospital. Something already happened. So what I had to do, I had to pull the plug. I ain't gonna be no hypocrite. But, I mean, because I pulled the plug on him. It ain't what I'm with. I'm not with it. Let them go. Hey. I pulled the plug because I seen where that was about to go. They wanted blood, they wanted clicks to make their pockets grow. Mm. They see this fire in my pen and think I'm dodging smoke. I would have lost the battle, dog. I would have lost the smoke. I would have gained a phone. Yeah. And all for what? Just to attain some more concentration. Like, that's what, like, listen to the. He said, I wouldn't have lost, you know, a battle. I would have lost a bro. And all for what? Just so y'all can get some more? Like, what am I doing that for? Like, and it's still back from, you know, I can't knock it if it's about to dough. Still off that. Bro, they see this fire in my pen and think I'm dodging smoke. I would have lost the battle, dog. I would have lost the bro. I would have lost the foe. And all for what? Just to attain some more. Props from strangers that don't got a clue what I've been aiming for. Since the age of 14. Jermaine is no king, if that means I gotta dig up dirt and pay the whole team. Yeah. Algorithm bot. Niggas. Just to sway the whole team. Things. He said, make it make sense to me. Are you telling me I didn't do all this? Like, I can't even beat myself if I had to go dig up some dirt on another man about nothing. Straight up, call I like that. Team, I got that team just to bridge for algorithm bot niggas. Media? Man, we rap, dog. He said, this ain't that. We ain't in, you know what I'm saying? We don't go to the, we hip hop, dog. We get in the streets. This social media, with it, they ain't for that. He said, hey, y'all want to see blood. Now, I think, I don't, you know, I'm not, nobody's really in comments in that, so I don't know. But I'm pretty sure it was people that kind of did want that to go there. So I can understand him saying that. But it's kind of just looking at it, like, you know, one way, because it's a lot of people that just want to hear, you know, just them all rap. And kind of looking back, it's kind of unfortunate that we didn't just get all of them just being able to rap. It was just like, we got what we got, which is great. But it's just like, dang, imagine just being able to have, like I said, the big three kind of rap battle and then the big three tours, the biggest tour of hip hop. It's like, that would be crazy. But at the same time, I ain't mad what we got. Because I'm still listening to Euphoria. And, what's my other one? Not Push-Ups. Family Matters, come on now. Family Matters, hell. Euphoria and Family Matters are my two favorites. Alright, man, we finna finish this call though. Team, Jermaine is no king, if that means I gotta dig up dirt, pay the whole team. Algorithm by niggas just to sway the whole thing. On social media, what? Competing for your favorable means to be considered best of living rest, the weight of both things. I understand. To be considered best to live and rest, the weight of both things. Like, listen to him. He said, the sitting be the best or the sitting rest. The way to both things, I could go attack this. Like, ah! And really get outside my body who I am and really go to do that when it's not in that spirit. I don't feel it that way. Yes, I want to be the best, but the way they want to go about being the best, I don't want to take it there. I'm going to have more respect for them than that. And you got to respect them for having that standpoint. And then, like I said, kind of redirecting it as quick as he did. I mean, 7 minutes drop, I like the song, but if it was kind of bothering, of course you don't want to hear that, but if it was bothering you that much to where, you know, you needed to pivot and get out of that, we got to be respectful of you doing that and standing on that, to be honest.
Thirsty being first that made them both swing,
protecting legacies. Oh, whoa. Now you talking about, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Being on social media, yeah. Competing for your favorable means to be considered best and living rest, the weight of both things. I understand the thirst of being first that made them both swing, protecting legacies. See? So lines got crossed, perhaps regrettably.
Bleed.
My friends went to war, I walked away with all
blood on me.
Now some will discredit me, try wipe away my pedigree,
but
find a nigga out that's rapping this
incredibly. My dog. I ain't gonna lie, the one thing I want to say though, he like. In that part, you know, a lot of people are saying that he, like, what's he talking about? He did, like, first of all, there are a lot of people saying nobody bleed. And two, that why does he feel like he the blood would be on him? I disagree. If there's going to be any blood, I could see them saying, I mean, clearly, life has changed majorly for one person. So, I mean, figuratively, that would be the blood, quote unquote. And then Kendrick being the victor. But then also, Cole, although Kendrick and Drake probably would have got to it eventually, Cole was the accelerator at the end of the day. Because it's just like, it's almost just like, I don't think it's like no snake jump. I don't think Cole wanted to go that way for real. But it's almost just like if, you know, two of your partners really don't mess with each other, they're really not cool like that. And it's like, your one partner's your man, so you like, shoot, no, what's the name? I'll be over there. You pulling up too. Oh, you like, for real? Yeah. And then your other partner, you don't tell him that your other partner pulling up. So then now your other partner, who you told, you know what I'm saying, do brain, and now you didn't, you know, beat him, boom. Then he's just like, dang. It's kind of on you, the blood is on your hand. Because you could have just gave both the same respect. Like, hey, nah, you just gave it to him. So I can see why people, or if anybody saying that, Cole feels like the blood is on his hands on those scenarios. Because it, minus his, you know, acknowledgement of the big three in the song, obviously first person shooter, you may not even have the start of this beef from there, which is like that.
Try wipe away my pedigree, but please find a nigga out that's rapping this incredibly. My dog texted me, I share the words he said to me. If you refuse to shoot a gun, don't mean the gun ain't deadly. I guess in that metaphor, hypothetically,
the gun is me.
I text him back like yesterday.
Gun ain't what I'm trying to be, my nigga. Hey, like, that's hard. I feel kind of two ways about this because it's only because he said a gun. Because I feel like 7 Minute Drill is a shot. So, we know he kind of retracted it, but once you shoot a gun, I mean, ain't no grabbing the bullet back out there. It ain't no, my fault. Nah, you shot. So, now we come back, shots fired, and you know what I'm saying? We can't, that already happened. So, that's the only thing I was kind of like, I see it, but you shot, for sure. But, that's a hard metaphor still. Because although I may have shot, I'm still not going to continue to be used as a gun. It's just like if you find out that I'm getting fucked over by somebody, why would you just continue to keep doing that? So it's just like, I realize that, you know, in this scenario, they're telling me that, you know, a gun is still a gun even if you don't shoot it. True. And then in that scenario, if that's the case, then I'm just saying that I don't want to be a gun. So I'd rather live with the decision of not being the gun than keep shooting. And I, like I said, that's respectful. Respectful.
To me, if you refuse to shoot the gun,
don't mean the gun ain't deadly.
I guess in that metaphor,
hypothetically, the gun is me.
I text him back like yes,
gun ain't what I was trying to be, my
nigga. Hey. They strip me on my spot.
Say I'm finally free, my nigga. Yeah.
They say I'm picking sides, and don't you lie on
me, my nigga. Yeah.
To start another war and drink, you'll always be my nigga.
Yeah.
I ain't ashamed to say you did a lot for me, my nigga. fuck all the narratives. Yeah. Tapping back into your magic pen is what's imperative. Reminding these folks why we
do. He said it. You know what I'm saying? Getting back to your pen is really what was needed. But only thing I don't really, it's like, that's the only thing on them, just like, I don't like that it feel like an apology to Drake. That's the only thing I didn't like. Like, I get that in the, cause I mean, to me, say like Kendrick's on, say like Kendrick too. Like Kendrick, I mean, I don't know, but I just feel like this seemed like a sympathy thing to Drake. It's just like, bruh, Drake probably over there like, nigga, I'm old. I mean, young, nigga's OVO. Nigga, you probably like OVO, as I told you, very young, dog. You old and turn, finna turn up. I'm not standing no, get back to my crowd, dog. We finna drop, no face, like, no face. We finna drop the video for no face or something, so. I can see that too, like, bro, why is you apologizing? Like, bro, it is what it is. You picked the side, if he feels that way, because I mean, Drake's in it, so, like, he feels that way, like, you picked the side, or you jumped out there, told me, hey, if we get in a fight, I'm fighting, and I done got jumped out here, you done left, now you're like, what happened? I'm sorry, bro, I didn't mean, I didn't know what was going on. He's like, nah, I'm cool, can't ride with it, so I get it. But that's the only thing I would say from that, but that I'm free, I think that says a lot, and especially, I'm gonna get to it in a second, but I'm free part, we're gonna table that right now.
All the narratives, tapping back into your magic pen is what's imperative. Yeah. Reminding these folks why we do it, it's not for beefing, it's for speaking our thoughts, pushing ourselves, reaching our charts, reaching our minds, keeping your hearts, creeping our minds, emotions to touch, something inside to open you up, help you cope with the rough
times and shit.
I'm sending love cause we ain't promised shit.
My name is not me. It's that part, it's big.
Things happening, stopping me.
And I think that one is what I think is a very big thing that he's saying. I think the song, it might be one of the most, like, because it's not promotion, because it's not like you go into an album, say, to follow. At this point, I think this is a great promotion for the album. It's just like, you know, like my last album I'm saying I'm gonna drop is called The Fall Off, which would be talking about how I fell off, how I kind of fucked it up. Almost like when the movie started, it's at the end, and you're probably like, oh, you probably think, wonder how I get here. When you say The Fall Off, it's kind of like, dang, you probably wonder how I got here. And then this might have just did his whole fall off kind of thing a whole nother way, because just like, now people even look at you kind of with a way like, Cole, like, some people do. I don't look Cole like that. But it's just like, some people kind of toot their nose up to like, oh man, y'all talking about him? And you hear him say, he said, I've been stripped of my what's name, now finally free, my, like, I done got stripped of that title. It's almost like a champion that loses his belt. So I done got stripped of the title, now I'm free. Like, I'm finally free from that. I had to hold, you know, this level of whatever to be that, and it actually feels better to have that stripped away from me taking. And I think that or being the momentum going into an album called The Fall Off that you've been working on for like 5 years is going to be crazy. So The Fall Off might be like instant classic, like off top. I think I might jump out and say it. Because I just feel like this is going to be a whole different kind of base of people that not even base of people, because it's not necessarily new people. It might just have to be the same people having new opinions and new feelings about the whole thing. So I can see that kind of lending to some momentum, like I said, going head into the fall off album whenever that's set to drop. No dates, but it's like he scrubbed a lot of stuff and kind of he's back outside, so we'll see. But like I said, that was a long video, I ain't gonna cap. But that boy, he was talking. Cole, the J. Cole, Port Antonio, y'all let me know what y'all think of the comments, think of the song. Also, what y'all think of, you know, following? Like I said, I think this really leads to the fall off in a very kind of that. This could be a seismic thing going into the album that could, like I said, make it classic, like off top. But like I said, man, that'd be it for this video, man. That was that. J. Cole, Port Antonio. Again, y'all let me know what y'all think of it in the comments. Like, share, comment, subscribe if y'all new. Other than that, see y'all in the next video. Peace.